Hello and welcome to part 4 on how to create a YouTube UI with React.js. In this part we are going to create the sidebar. I will make the sidebar buttons and I'm going to create a divider so we can divide sections in our sidebar. So let's get started right away. So to start off, I have opened up the development server on localhost 3000 and I have opened up the YouTube page. And I'm going to start with the sidebar section right here. So for that I'm going to create a new component. I'm going to create a sidebar. And I'm going to create the default code. Like so. And I'm going to make it return a div with sidebar in it. Like so. And then I want to import the sidebar inside of my page. So let's see. Right now we have everything in our app component. And then we have our navbar, and underneath there I want my sidebar, like so. And if I refresh the page, we'll see that we have our sidebar right here. And I'm actually also going to create the container for our content already. So as you can see, the YouTube page has a navigation bar, a sidebar which we can scroll in, and the content section, which is on the right. So I'm also going to create a component for that one, so content. And I'm going to call it content section. And then I'm going to import the same things which I did from the sidebar, like so. And I'm going to change this to content section, and this as well. And I'm also going to import this in my app.jsx. So I'm going to say content section, like so. And now we have our content right here. And I actually want the sidebar to have a little bit of space and the content to have most of the space. So let's see. To do that, I'm going to be using, I think, flags. So I have the navigation bar at the top and then two elements or two sections on the middle of the page. So I could also use a grid. So I think I'm going with a grid since I think that is more appropriate for this situation. So we will have a grid for the sidebar and a grid section for the content. And I'm going to wrap those two into a div, which will contain the grid. So this div will be the main page. Well, I'm just going to call it main container, like so. And inside of here, I have my sidebar and content section. And I can style it in my app.css. I can say main container. And then I want to say that I want to display it as a grid. And now nothing has changed yet. But now I can define my grid sections. So I can say grid template areas. And then I can define a sidebar area and a main or a content area, like so. And then I want to define in my CSS from the sidebar. That let's see, right here we have our sidebar container, like so. And for the content, we also have a content container. So right here, content container. And I'm going to style those two. And I'm going to say, I think I can say grid area. And I want to say that it has to be the content area. So if I look at the app.css, we named it content, and the sidebar will be the sidebar area. Grid area sidebar. So it should show next to each other. So let's see, we have our content and our sidebar. But as we can see, it is not showing next to each other. So we have two areas, okay? And we have this area. Do we need to add, no, we don't need to add parentheses. Oh, okay, so this is showing something. But I thought that like when we give those properties to the template areas that we would like show it in a grid like so. But maybe the reason is because our grid has our grid area has the full width of the page. So this one has the full width of the page and this one. And to fix that, I can go to my grid where I define it, and I can say grid template columns. And I want to say that we want to divide the space between the columns. So let's see. Right now we still have the same result, but as you can see, the sidebar and the content now have only 50% of the width. So that's working already correctly. Okay, so I see the mistake that I made. Since they are being displayed next to each other, I should also include them next to each other. So I have to write it like this, and now it will recognize it as two separate columns. So if I save this, we'll see that we have our two columns being ready and displayed. And what I can do now is I can change the width of the columns. So for example, I can say that the first column only has a width of 100 pixels, like so. And as you can see, our sidebar is now 100 pixels and the content is increasing its width all the way to the end of the page. And I'm curious if I leave this empty. Yes, okay, so now it will divide the width between those two. But I think I'm going to go with one fractional unit for the sidebar and 10 fractional units for the content. So we'll end up with something like this. And maybe I want to, also give a background so we can see more clearly what's going on. So the background color of this is the same color as the navigation bar, I think. So we have our sidebar, and I want to give it a background color of this. And I want to give it a color of white, otherwise we won't see the text. Yes. And for the main page, I want this color. So let's see, it will be this one. And this is where the content section will live. So background color, this one. And I want to give it a color of white so we can see the text. And right now we have something like this. And I think this is a little bit too small. So I'm going to increase it to 2 fractional units. And that might be too much. So instead of giving the sidebar a fractional unit, I'm going to give it a fixed width, which will be 300 pixels, I think. And now the sidebar will have 300 pixels and the content will have the rest of the space available. So I'm going to decrease it to 250. And I think we have a nice width for the sidebar. I might even decrease it to 240, like so. At next, I actually also want to include our navigation bar inside of our grid, since then we are taking full advantage of the grid that we are using. So instead of creating the grid in the main container, I'm going to remove this. And I'm going to add it to the page container. So right here, I want to say page container. And then I want to add here the navigation bar, like so. And as you can see, I am creating 2D grid. So on the first row, we have our navbar with a navbar, so that will take the full size of the row. On the second row, we have our sidebar, which is right, right on the left, and the content, which is on the right. Since the navbar is occupying both spaces on the top, it will always fill the top, so that's good. But as we can see in our HTML, the layout is a little bit messed up. And to fix that, I'm going to go into the navigation bar. And I think I have to say which grid areas it is using. So just as with our content section, I have to say grid area. So in my navbar.css, I'm going to say display flex. I'm going to say grid area, and then I want to say navbar, like so. And now we have a nice little navbar, it's a little bit big. So to fix this, I'm going to give the first grid row a fixed height, and then the rest of the rows will have the remaining space. So just as that we did with our columns, I'm going to do the same for our rows. So grid template rows. Oh, And I want to say that the first row has a height of, what did I give it before? It didn't have a fixed height, so maybe something like 80 pixels, and then the rest I want 1fr. And I can also say 1fr since this will always occupy the space available. So that's already a lot better, and I think I might even want to decrease it to 60 pixels. So I think 50 maybe, 55. Yeah, so we had something like this, and as you can see we still have the same result, but now we are taking full advantage of the grid since we are also including our navbar in it. And now we can just place those three components right here without having to worry about the position of them. So great. What we are going to do now is we are going to create the sidebar right here, and I'm going to create the first three, maybe five icons with buttons for the sidebar. So I'm first going to import those icons in my sidebar. So in my sidebar.tsx, I'm going to import the home icon from material icons and then from home. Next up we have our trending icon, so this will be the what's hot icon. Let's see, what's hot, like so. Then we have the subscriptions icon from subscriptions. Yes, and I don't think we have a trending icon, do we? No, so I'm going to keep the what's hot. And then we have the library. Like so. And then to finish it off, I'm going to import the history icon. So history icon from history. And next up, I want to use those icons in my sidebar. So I'm just going to plain copy them over inside the sidebar. And I'm going to say home icon, what's hot icon, subscriptions icon, video library icon, and the history icon. So let's see. Yeah, okay, great. So that's working. And I next want to, let's see, what should we do first? I'm going to create a button, which will be just a div, I think. Well, we're going to create a button with a normal background, which is just the color of the navbar, or maybe no background. When you hover over it, I want this lighter background, and then I want an icon with a label. So that's what we're going to do. And when I hover over it, I want, let's see, this trending subscriptions home, this placeholder to appear, so we can see what we are hovering on. Okay, so I'm going to start off with the home icon. I'm going to create a button, and I'm going to give this one a class name of sidebar button, like so. And let's see, I'm going to close those since I won't be needing them, and I'm going to target that one, and I want to say that I want also a label in it. So I'm going to say span, and then I want to say home. Yes, and then I want to display them next to each other, so we can do that by using display flex and align items of center, like so. Then I want to make them white. Yes, then I want to make the background color invisible, since we will be using the background color of the sidebar. Or I might be using the background color of the sidebar, I don't know. So none doesn't seem to work. Transparent, that does work. So I can make it or transparent or just the background color of our navbar or our sidebar. But I think I'm going to go with the sidebar, since otherwise if we change the color of the sidebar, our button color might change, which is not actually what we want. Next up I'm going to remove the padding, like so, and then I want to remove the border, Yes. Then I want to make the button being hoverable, like so. And then next up, I want to make it fill the entire width of the page. So let's see. I'm going to give this one a background of purple so we can see how big the button is. And if I say right here, a width of 100%, we are getting the width of 100%, so that's working correctly. And next, I want to give it a little bit more height. So I think I'm going to give it, let's say, 150 pixels of height. 150 pixels. No, wait, that's way too much. 50 pixels. Better, but I think 40 is even better. Yes, nice. And then I want to center, or well, not center, I want to have a padding on the left side of our content of the button. So I will be applying that to the home icon, I think, which is an SVG, so I can target it by the SVG tag. So I can say that I want to target the SVG and I want the padding left of 25 pixels. Yes, nice. And then I want the padding right on the SVG as well. So maybe also 25 pixels. So we have a little bit of space between our icon and our label, like so. Okay, that looks good already. Next, I want to, let's see. As you can see, we have a little bit of spacing between the navbar and the sidebar. So to the sidebar, I'm going to add a padding top, I think. So I'm going to add that right here. 10 pixels maybe. Yes, yeah. So as you can see, maybe even 15. We now have just like as on page a little bit of spacing between the navbar and the sidebar. So that's good. And next up, I want to remove the purple background since that's not the final color that we want to use. Like so. And then I want to get the color of the hoverable button. So that will be this color. Yes. And then I want to say when you hover over it, I want to change the background color to this color. Yeah. And when I hover over it, you can see that we get the correct color. So that's great. So next up, I'm going to create the trend link subscriptions, library and history buttons. So I can actually copy over this button and I can move it underneath here, or I can also use a separate component for it. So in my components, I can create a new folder, which will be the, let's see how I'm going to call it, sidebar button. And in my sidebar button, I can create a new component with some styling. Sidebar button, like so. And this one also sidebar button with one R. Yeah. And then here the CSS. And I'm going to really quick add the imports. Like so. And I want to return a button. And inside this button, we want a icon and a span. Is this the case for every button? Mostly, yeah. Okay, so let's see. I'm going to be accepting, let's see, a icon and a span. Yes. Do we want to accept that? I think so. So I'm going to add a interface. And we want a icon, which will be of type any. And I want a label of type string. And I expect those to be delivered. So icon and label of type props. And then right here, I want to render the icon. So the icon is actually an element. So how are we going to do this? I'm going to do this by rendering it like so, icon. And then I can render the label right here by saying span and then label. I want the variable label like so. And if I save this, it's going to complain that we have to deliver, oh, nothing. So I'm going to add the sidebar button right here first, sidebar button, and then it's going to complain, hopefully. So right now it doesn't say anything. It's not defined, so I still have to import it. I've imported it right here. And if I save it up, it will say, hey, we missed the type icon and label, or the prop icon and label. So I'm going to say icon will be home icon. I hope I can pass it in like this. I don't know if I can though. So what if I say home icon like so? And then like so. Yes, and then I want the label to be a span. Oh well, not span, home. I meant home, okay, sorry. And I want to remove the sidebar button class from here. And I want to add it right here. So this will have a class name of sidebar button, like so. And then I want to remove the sidebar button styling right here. And then I want to move it in my sidebar button.css. Go to remove the parent selector, and if I save this up, we will see our nice little sidebar icon appearing right here. And now we can really easily reuse this component for the what's hot icon and the subscription icon. So I could just say what's hot and subscriptions, and I can delete those two. Here we can say let's see, trending. And right here, I think subscriptions. So if I save this up, we will see, yeah, nice, okay. We will see our icons being rendered with the label inside of a different components. So that's really good. Only thing I want to add right now is I want to add the lower border, so we can separate those from those icons. Well, but first I'm actually going to continue on creating our cool new icons. So right here I'm going to say video library, and this will be library, and then the next one will be history. So this will be the history icon, like so. And if I refresh the page, we will see our new icons appearing. Nice, good. I want to make the icons a little bit grayish, so the text is white, so that's good, but the icon should be not so white. So for the SVG, I'm going to give it a color of RGB, and then I think 200, like so. And I might even want to make it a little bit darker, so 180 I think, or maybe 150, something like that. 180 looks good, but I'm going to keep it at 150. Nice, okay, yeah. And then when we hover over the button, we will see the nice little background changing, so that's good. Let's see, next up I want to create the border at the bottom right here. So for creating the border, I think I'm going to wrap this in a section. So this will be like the we have home, trending, and subscriptions. But instead of using sections, naming sections, I think I'm going to create an abstract class, which will be just a section. And I think that I'm going to, let's see, edit at the bottom. So I think I'm going to wrap this in a div. And then I want to say that we want a border bottom on this div. But what I can also use, actually, I think I'm going to do that, since that seems more appropriate. So for this, I'm going to say class name equals divider. So now we have a divider standing right here, which is not shown right here. But the cool thing we can do with the divider is that we can make it divide. So I want to target the divider, And I want to set it what a width of 100% and a height of 1 pixel, and then a bottom border bottom. Oh. Border bottom of RGB, and then I think the same color as the icons. So let's stick with 150. And if we refresh the page, nothing will happen. Okay, so let's see if we can actually see the divider. So the divider is here, but we are not seeing it. So let's see, if I increase the height, will it make any difference? No. So the height is okay. The width is also okay, since it says 240 pixels. Oh wait, I have to give the border bottom a width, I think. So border bottom width, 1 pixel. Okay, so no, that didn't do anything else. If I increase the border bottom width to 7 pixels, also not really working. Okay, so it's really not going along right now. Okay, I'm seeing what I did wrong. It's a really bad mistake. If you say border bottom, you have to specify the width. So the type of line, so this will be solid, and I specify the width and then the color. So it will be a solid 1 pixel, and then RGB, and then 150. So now the divider is showing. That's good, but we want to make it a little bit darker. So I'm going to keep it at 50, I think. Yeah, nice. And then I want to make it divide even more. And to make it divide even more, I'm going to add a little bit of padding to it. So I'm going to add a padding vertically to it, which will be 15 pixels. And as you can see, now we have a nice little division between the top and the bottom of our elements. But the top is a little bit more divided. So the division is happening at the border bottom. So I don't know if I want to use a padding. I might want to use a margin. Yes, so that looks better. Let's see, I might even want to decrease it to 10 pixels. And let's see, can we remove the width, or is that still necessary? So the width isn't even necessary, and the height, that's one either. Okay, so we can just use a margin vertically, 10 pixels, and then a border bottom of solid, 1 pixel, and then 50 RGB. So then we have this result, which looks really cool. We have the same divider as on the YouTube page. And to wrap it up, I think I'm going to fix the sidebar scrolling along with the content. So I want the sidebar to be fixed on the page. So as you can guess from the words that I used, I'm going to give it a position of fixed right here. I'm going to say position and then fixed. Okay, so that is not exactly what I want, but it's kind of what I want though. Let's see, right now our sidebar is right here. So to correctly position our sidebar, I'm going to get it off the grid, and I'm going to be using a fixed position, so I can remove the grid area, and then I can give it a top of 55 pixels and a width of 240 pixels. So it will look like this, and then when we will make our sidebar grow, we will see that the background of the page is also changing into the background of the sidebar. So right now we have this, and if I scroll on the page, you can see that the sidebar is staying in place. So that's actually what we are trying to achieve. So I'm going to remove the grid area, unfortunately, and I'm going to add a top of 55 pixels, and then right here a width of 240 pixels, like so. And I actually want to make the background of the page maybe a different color, or to test out how the sidebar is going to look if we have more content inside of it, I'm going to also give it a height of 120 view height, like so. So right now, if we scroll on the page, our sidebar will stay in place, and we cannot scroll on the sidebar right now. So let's see, I'm going to give it a scroll Y. Or what is it called? Overflow Y of scroll. And now we can scroll on the sidebar, I think. So I actually don't see any scroll bars. Maybe I need to increase the height a little bit more. No, I can still not really scroll on the sidebar. So to test the scrolling of the sidebar, I'm going to copy over this section of the sidebar and I'm going to paste it in like 7 times. And then when we refresh the page, we will see that we have our sidebar right here and that we can scroll on it. So the reason why we can scroll is because we have applied the overall Y of scroll and we have defined a height of the sidebar. So right now you can see that we have the height of 50 feet wide. So we can scroll until the half of the page. So if I increase this to 100, we will get 100 of the view height and we can scroll until the bottom of the page. But one problem that we'll have is that we won't see the ending of the sidebar. So if I say right here ending, and then for example right here pre-ending and save the page, we will see that we see our pre-ending, but we are not being able to view our ending. And it's because it is not 100 view height, but actually 100 view height minus 55 pixels from the top of the page. So to fix this, I can say that I want to calculate the difference between 100 view height minus 55 pixels, since this is the top position from the sidebar. So if I save this up, we will see that we are being able to see our pre-ending and almost our ending. So this fixed it a little bit, but to fix it totally, I think I'm going to also give it a padding bottom. So instead of only padding top, I'm going to say padding 50 pixels, 0 pixels. So now we have a little bit of padding at the bottom, but we are still not able to view our ending. And if I increase this to 50 pixels, we will see that we have even less to view. So I'm going to keep this at padding top. And I think I'm going to take the padding top into account right here. And I'm going to give it 70 pixels from the top. Yes, okay. So that was the solution. We also have to take in account for the padding and then we can calculate the height. So right now we will see the last thing that we put right here, which is the ending and the pre-ending as well. So if I remove this, we'll see our nice sidebar being able to scroll and we will have our main content section, which is also being able to scroll. So that will be this for this episode. In the next episode, I'm going to be working further on the sidebar. I'm going to add the label when we hover over a button and I'm going to add the rest of the sidebar to the page. So I want to thank you for watching and I hope I see you again in the next episode. Bye!